Welcome back. My name is Chris, and this is going to be a NetSuite tutorial. So in this video, I'm assuming that you've never used NetSuite before, and this is really going to be a crash course on how to navigate through NetSuite, some of the key functions that you need to know, and really how to get yourself around in NetSuite. If you need something that's a bit longer or more in-depth on the basics of NetSuite, check out my much longer video on NetSuite for Beginners. And if you really want to get more familiar with NetSuite, I have an entire Basics of NetSuite course. You can click the link below, and it's got 50 videos. It really shows you everything that a new user might need to know about NetSuite. And I do have more advanced courses as well. So let's now dive into NetSuite and check out some of the basic functions and characteristics of your new NetSuite role. So here we are in the home dashboard, and really this is going to be the first thing you see when you log in, and this is going to be your home base when doing really anything in NetSuite. So as you can see, we've got a lot going on here, and honestly, if you find this a bit too hectic, you can always come over here onto the right and go to layout and do a layout that's a bit simpler, a bit less to take in at once. So in this case, I've done a layout which is much simpler. It's just got two columns, and all these windows, for example, you can see this little reminders window here. These windows are all referred to as portlets. So you basically got a bunch of portlets here, and these portlets are going to be tailored to what your role is. So if I go in the top right here, I'm Carol Morgan right now, and I'm in the role of the controller. So because I'm in this particular role, NetSuite actually comes, they make these dashboards pre-built with all of these different portlets that relate to that role and things that that role probably would need. So as a controller, I have things like, these are basically shortcuts that bring me the balance sheet, the trial balance, income statement, et cetera. This portlet's particularly helpful. This is a reminders portlet, and every role has one of these tailored to the things that that role should see as reminders. So in this case, this controller needs to approve several sales orders, needs to approve a return for authorization. As an inventory manager, you might have fulfillments that you have to do listed there in the reminders. So that's a great just kind of hub or inbox to see what are the various transactions that you need to, or records you need to interact with as a part of your job. We've also got things like KPIs, and again, tons of different portlets here. You might not find them helpful and you don't have to use them, but they all have the ability. If I come to the top right here, I can hit setup and it'll give me the ability to customize how that portlet looks. I can have less on it, I can have more there, I can minimize it. A lot of different things you can do to customize your particular dashboard. So a few other things I wanna orient you to on here. We've got this blue bar here at the top, and what this is called a center. So, and I refer to this often as the navigation bar, because that's really what you use to navigate into NetSuite. And really what it's composed of is a bunch of tabs. In this case, and what you'll see is these tabs are all going to be related to the role that you're in. So any accounting-based role, like a controller that I'm in, is going to get this accounting center. So as you can see, it's got all of these different tabs that relate to accounting. A sales manager, for example, let's actually switch roles here and see how it differs. I'll actually go down to inventory manager. Okay, and so now I'm in the role, I'm Nick Singh, and I'm in the inventory manager role. And you can see all of these different things on the dashboard have now changed to fit an inventory manager. So I've got things like inventory transfer, adjustments, et cetera. I can see there's certain tasks overdue. I also can see those orders that I need to fulfill. So that gives you a concept, but most importantly, like I was speaking about before, we've got the center now looks wildly different than when I was in that accounting center. So if you hover over any one of these tabs, you basically have all these dropdowns that provide various functions and areas in NetSuite that might fit your roles. So in the beginning, that can be a little bit overwhelming, but really, as you're dealing with a specific role, just kind of go through those tabs and kind of get familiar. Like for example, if you want to know, if you want to pull up a bunch of reports, well, you're obviously going to go to the reports tab and you can kind of get the grasp of what you're looking at. For example, these tabs down here show you all different types of reports that you can pull up. So let's take a look at one of those. Let's look at the chart of accounts. And this is a financial type report. So it pulls up this report and it allows us to look at the chart of accounts. Now, as the inventory manager, that might not be as helpful, but certainly if I was in an AP analyst or a controller type role, I might want to look at things like the income statement, et cetera. So we've got reports there. We can also do save searches. So if I go down here and I go to new search, I can start the process of creating a save search, which is really a type of report where you're gonna set criteria and it's gonna go through the entire system and pull out information based on the criteria that you've set. Now, I'm not gonna do a saved search in this particular video because that's a bit over this. So if you wanna check out how to do those, check out any of my other videos on saved searches. I've made very many in that area, but that is always a function that you can utilize. Now, if I wanna go back to my home dashboard, especially as kind of an orientation square zero, I can always go to my center here and click on this little home button to take me back to that home dashboard. I also have the ability, if you can see here, set preferences. If you wanna do things like customize your particular role, your setup, it's not gonna affect anyone else. You're gonna click on that set preferences and you can do things like change the color. You can change the way dates are formatted, all different types of things by just setting those preferences for you as your role. You also have a couple other things available here, such as this star, which they call it shortcuts, but really it's like favorites. It's the exact same function. So if you have certain records you go to all the time, or maybe certain saved searches that you commonly use, you can save them as shortcuts and you can easily get back to them. We also have the history here. So if you hover over that, just like any browser history, it's gonna show you all the recent records or transactions that you've interacted with. So that's an easy way to go back to something that you were previously dealing with. Now on the top here, I have already covered the fact that you've got your role. So if you have multiple roles available to you, or maybe you're the inventory manager, but you also have an employee center, you can always hover over this and it will provide all the roles you have available so you can switch easily between those roles. And then this button over here is actually quite helpful. You don't see anything available here, but this is called the new record button. And what this does is it allows you to generate whatever new records that you're going to need to interact with as part of your job. So maybe you need to create new sales orders or purchase orders, maybe new customers, whatever that type of record is, you're going to add those records on here. For example, if you hit personalize, it'll give you all the different types of records or transactions you can possibly create. And you can add them onto this button. So when you hover over this, it's got everything you could possibly need. If you want to create a new event or activity, you can simply add them in there and then you can click them and generate that new type of record. The next thing I want to show you is this global search bar. So this is your ability. This search bar here specifically is going to look through the entire system for whatever you need. So you can put in a type of customer. You can also, there's various ways of really narrowing down by putting in things like CUS. It's gonna actually narrow that search down by customers. And again, I've made an entire video that shows how to use the global search bar and how to best optimize those searches to narrow things down to give you the exact kind of records you need. But that's a great tool for, instead of maybe using a saved search or some of these more elaborate reporting tools, you can simply search through the system and pull up whatever it is you need. Now, because we're in the inventory manager role, let's take a look at how inventory planning and management would be handled in NetSuite. So if I go down here to inventory, I can go down to lists. And if I come up here, I've got items. So if I click on that, it's gonna generate a list of every single item that we currently have in this NetSuite. We call it, refer to it as an instance. In other words, what your company's using as NetSuite is your NetSuite instance. So here I can see all the items in this NetSuite instance. And let's say I want to check out this Dell monitor. I can hit edit here and it'll pull up that record. So we can see the actual item here. We can see all the various elements that go into it, all the aspects of how it's stocked, their purchasing, how the inventory is managed. In this case, it's handled by MRP. We can see that right here. We could set all the various aspects of how the demand planning goes, how the lead times are, how we want to adjust inventory or generate new, maybe we want to have reorder points as part of our inventory management. We can also do things like setting the sales and the pricings for various things. So as you can see, this is just one example of a record. You have all these different fields that you can interact with. And again, I have videos really breaking down all of these things to make it as simple as possible, but in whatever role you're dealing with, there's really only a few things that you're gonna be doing. So you really get familiar with how these records look and how to navigate them. So let's actually switch roles at this point and show how we can do something more along a sales line in terms of generating a new sales order. So first off, I'm gonna switch to a role that's more applicable for that type of thing. So I'm gonna go down and I'm gonna go to the sales manager role. I'm gonna say leave this. So I'm leaving this particular inventory manager role. So now I'm here in the sales manager role. So let's say we want to generate a new sales order. We go up to this new button and we can see we can create things like leads, customers, et cetera, but we want to generate a sales order. So we'll click this button and it brings us to this sales order record. So here's where we can put in, for example, if we click on this field here, we can go to our list of all the available customers we have. Let's say Devavu is the customer we're gonna be selling to. So we can click on that. And because we have that customer already in the system, it generates things like what subsidiary the customer is associated with. So we can scroll down here actually, and you can see within this items subtab here, we've got this whole list of where we can put in what are the things that this customer is buying. So let's actually click here and look at our full list of items. And let's say that the customer purchased a Dell monitor. So we've added that and we can put the quantity. Let's say the quantity is 2 monitors. And based on setting that quantity, we can see not only the base price per unit, but also the total amount, whether it's taxable or not, et cetera. So we can add this item and we can then go down and save this sales order. All right, and we can see that sales order was successfully saved and it's now gone through pending approval. So we could actually hit approve. In this case, because we're the sales manager, we have the ability to approve this sales order. And we've now sent that sales order over to item fulfillment. So we've pushed it along that order to cash process flow, which is a standard process flow within NetSuite. And of course, the exact same capabilities are there for the purchase order side of things. So if you're generating purchase orders, maybe restocking inventory, or even getting some supplies for yourself as an employee, you can do the exact same thing for purchase orders. And that's a basic NetSuite tutorial for a brand new user in NetSuite. If you want to check out some other videos that really go more into depth on how to use some of the functions in NetSuite, just go to my channel and check those out. And if you found this video helpful, please hit that like button, subscribe for future videos, and as always, I'll see you in the next video.